The rest of the vector-based tools work differently from the type tool. First, you need to create a shape made out of path and anchor points. Anchor points and path, the lines that connect anchor points. And then you choose what you want to do with that. You can fill it with color or pattern. Outline your shape. Or convert it into selection. Vector tools in the toolbox can be divided into two groups: path creating tools like pens and shapes. With any path creating tool selected, in addition to choosing tool from the toolbox, you also have an option to switch between them in the option bar. Editing tools like add, delete, and convert anchor points, as well as path selection tool and direct selection tool, are used to transform and modify already existing shapes. Let's go over path creating tools first. The pen tool is used to draw freeform shapes. It works similar to polygon selection tool. Just click and release your mouse to set the anchor points. Then Adobe Photoshop will connect the points with lines. To close the shape, roll cursor over to the starting point, then click and release. In addition to straight lines connecting anchor points, you can create curves. To draw curves, click and drag the cursor to set the direction, then release the mouse. You can also create a combination of curves and straight lines. Let's move this first. To create a curve, click, drag, and release the mouse. To create a straight line, click and release. Unless you close the shape, the pen tool will continue to draw the path as you click on the document. To exit the command, simply click on any tool in the toolbox or option bar. This will deselect the path, making it inactive. Or you can simply close the shape. The pen is the most confusing tool for beginners. It takes time, practice, and skills. In my practical skills Adobe Illustrator tutorial, we had to create an entire chapter covering the pen tool. But when you get comfortable with it, pen will be your favorite for creating vector graphics. A freehand pen tool allows you to create paths with freehand movement, very similar to freehand lasso selection tool. Simply click and drag the cursor and release the mouse when you are done. Check magnetic option to convert the freehand pen tool into a magnetic pen tool. This option is best used for tracing images. It works by recognizing colors and contrasts in your artwork. Being very similar to the magnetic lasso selection tool, magnetic pen creates path by snapping to points around the edges of the area being traced. Press Escape key if you're not happy with the path to start over. Click and release the mouse to start the path. Then move cursor around the desired area. The magnetic pen will snap in place along the way, creating curves, lines, and anchor points as you trace. Click and release to set your own anchor points. Roll the cursor over to the initial anchor point, click and release to close the path. The rest of the path creating tools draw a path based on the shape description, like rectangular, ellipse, polygon, or line tool. Select the desired shape. Click and drag on your document. Release the mouse when you are happy with the size of the shape. Each path creating tool has its own geometry options. To view, click on the black triangle in the option bar. For example, rectangular tool geometry allows you to set proportions and size or keep it unconstrained, very similar to the rectangular marquee selection tool. While we are not going to cover each tool and its options, it's a good idea for you to check them out and see how they work. Rounded rectangular, polygon, line, and custom shape tool have additional options you need to pay attention to. Rounded rectangular allows you to change radius. To change the size of the curve. With polygon tool, you can set the different number of sides. Change geometry to star. Change the weight for the line tool. And finally, custom shapes have variety of shapes to choose from the sample menu. You can also define your own path as a custom shape. To define custom shape, first create the shape you want to define. Then right-click on your document and choose Define Custom Shape. You can also go to Edit, Define Custom Shape. Name it and click OK. Adobe Photoshop will add it to the Custom Shape sample menu. Here it is.